Hello everyone, it's Rad. Welcome to Rad Tarot channel, and this video is going to contain a general tarot reading. And for that reason, as general tarot reading, the reading itself is going to relate to different subjects and situations and is going to manifest itself in a different way with every single different person. Now, in case you are interested to know about specifically about your personal situation, you can check out my website, which is listed here in the display, or it is as well shown in the description of the video. And there you are going to find, visiting it, you are going to find on the very front page full list of my services as well as their pricing, starting from just as little as $12 for the recorded readings and $15 for the private call readings. Apart from that, if you want to see me live, or you know, you want to contribute with an event on me, you can check out my Facebook page, which as well you can see here on the video or in the description down below, and consider sharing and subscribing the video, because this is a one-man operation and your support does helps a lot. That being said, I want you now to lay back comfortably and enjoy the show. Okay, so this is going to be a Cancer Sun, Cancer Moon, and Cancer Rising. Weekly tarot reading, July 15th to July 21st, 2019. And bear with me a second, guys, to shuffle the tarot cards. And we're going to jump straight away into the reading. Alright, so the first card, which represents the topic for Cancer's week, this is going to be the Ace of Pentacles, followed by the second card, which stands for the challenges that Cancer needs to face this week. This is going to be the Five of Cups. Afterwards, we do have the positive aspect of the week. We do have the Ten of Cups. And then the last one here is going to be the guidance card that Tarot is offering to you, Cancer. We do have the Two of Pentacles. Alright, so once again, Ace of Pentacles, it is the positive aspect, followed by the Five of Cups, which stands for the challenges. Afterwards is going to be the Ten of Cups, which regards to the positive aspect. And then the last one is going to be the Two of Pentacles, which stands for the guidance. It looks quite promising, guys, I'm not gonna lie to you, as the Ace of Pentacles is always a very positive card. I mean, when you do have the Ace of Pentacles as the very start of the reading, at the very start of the spread, excuse me, which spread is a chain and follow the same narrative, it simply cannot go any wrong, all right? Because the Ace of Pentacles is this card which points that, you know, you do have that rare opportunity to further your goal, if not anything else. But the Ace of Pentacles itself promises a week, as it is the topic of the week. So a week of a lot of content, right? And a lot of productivity as well. A week where you're going to establish a successful business, for example, or you're going to be very successful in what you do in regards to career. And also it kind of promises a harmoniously flowing relationships, friendships, romantic, you know, flirting and all these kind of stuff. Now, the only thing that can really ruin the experience of the Ace of Pentacles is if you rush the whole thing and you don't take the necessary time to make your preparations. For example, you're going out on a date, or take your time to make your, to do your makeup, you know, to do your dressings as well. I mean, no one wants to see you with wearing a sloppy raiment, all right? It's all about kind of like picking up accordingly your attire, or how you're going to go forward with it, or if you are involved into a big project, take your time, think it thoroughly, you know, scrutinize the information that you do have about it and just act accordingly. Just don't rush that situation. Just don't rush this opportunity which is given to you throughout this week, July 15th to July 21st. The accompanied card here is going to be the Queen of Pentacles. And the formation is a passive supporters. And what do you know? Now, this is something that you haven't developed yet. What I mean is that it was always around you, okay? But you haven't thought over it as a potential of yours, okay? So if this, let me give you an example here to tell you what I'm talking about. So if this is about a new suitor, well, then as a unfound potential, these cards are pointing that that suitor is already around you. It's not going to be someone new, okay? Or if this is about improvement into your current relationship or a marriage, it's going to be in regards to an enterprise that you already considered with your husband. Or if it is about your career, then you're going to be involved in a project that is already existing, okay? It's just something that is around you, okay, which you have not incorporated your potential in it yet, but you are going to have the chance throughout this week. And as we saw, obviously is going to significantly improve your status, your relationship, and your career as well. But that is if you take advantage of it, okay? Because tarot is never built up to make decisions for you. So we cannot say anything that is carved in stones. What we talk about is potential, possibilities, opportunities. And if you don't take that opportunity, well, then nothing kind of like extraordinary is going to happen to you. So the challenges here are the Five of Cups. And that is a kind of baffling card because it does point to, how can I describe it? A partial loss, right? A loss which is not like losing everything, but in the same time, it's kind of going to make you a bit disappointed, at the very least. Now, that is as well partial loss, which is not going to cost you any self-respect. And this usually, it is because this loss is not your fault, okay? That is usually what the card does describe. You did nothing wrong, okay? But either this thing was not meant for you to happen, or either someone else screwed up. No different, for example, that if someone tries to be with a specific person, but that person is already in love with someone else. So it's not the fault of the one that wants to be with D, all right? It is just they are not meant to be because D loves someone else, all right? Something like that. The accompanied card is going to be the Ace of Swords. And this is even more strange than only the Five of Cups. Now the Ace of Swords falls as a passive neutral to the Five of Cups. And it kind of like what this combination here points is that you are denying to understand or to comprehend the reason why you are experiencing those losses. Okay. No different than if we are following the narrative here of one is chasing someone that is loving someone else, okay? This one which is chasing does not understand why that person doesn't love them, as in their own vision and image, they have everything to beat the third party. But sometimes you don't get to understand how things works, okay? So with that particular narrative, what these cards here are urging you is not to push very hard, all right? Especially in those kind of directions which things are simply doesn't want to happen. For example, if someone doesn't want to be with you, say them farewell and just go somewhere else where, or associate yourself with someone else which wants to be with you, you know? Or if your boss doesn't want to give you a specific project, just, you know, abandon this idea and see what else your boss can give you, all right? Because there is going to be definitely something else that they can give you. It's just what is scribed here with the first couple of cards, which is the very topic of the week. And even moreover, you know, as we said in the topic, it's going to be an unfound potential, all right? So it's something that you haven't considered until this very moment. And then we go to the positive aspect of the week, and that is going to be the Ten of Cups. So what we have here, it's happiness, okay? Ten of Cups is always about happiness, but it's going to be different for the different Cancer. And because the Ten of Cups does describe two types of happiness. One of the happinesses is that one is grateful for the blessings that one has, and simply one is ready to indulge with them. I mean, one realizes that even though one does not have everything, one does have enough to be happy. And the other, which is much more advanced, and I mean advanced at time, is when one already indulged, already, you know, consumed all that happiness, and now one is ready to conquer even more. It's going to be different for every single one of you, but whatever it is, you know, I do believe that you're going to be in peace with this different opportunity to further your goal, because under further your goal, I don't mean the goal to be involved with that specific project. I mean the goal to be successful. And you can be successful in many different projects into your career. Or the goal to be happy. You may not be happy with that specific person, but there is someone else that can make you happy, all right? So be open-minded. It is what the point of the reading is. And that is, as a matter of fact, the last card, but we're going to go there in a minute. So the accompanied card here is going to be the King of Cups, and the formation, it is the passive supporters. And these cards are pointing to a extreme emotional satisfaction. What I mean here, it is not like a outbursting in an emotional glee, all right? What I mean here is that you are going to be very emotionally satisfied for what you already have, grateful for the opportunities into your career, grateful that you do have a family, for example, grateful that you are, you know, single and you do have an opportunities to play with as well. It's just, you know, even though you may not have everything, what you do have is going to stand out more for what you don't have. And that will make you adopt a standpoint where you're going to be in peace, not being afraid to try for more. Because an opportunity to try for more, like I said, is going to be given to you throughout this week. Not to mention that because you are finding yourself in this state of peace, you will be able to make good decisions, because the King of Cups, it's all about making good, balanced, professional, if you want to say, decisions. And also, one last thing about these couple of cards, that opportunity could come through a surprising, tempting offer, right? Or through a surprising coming out a helping hand, okay? Surprising helping hand which comes around. So the guidance. Now I'm going to start from afar with the guidance, Two of Pentacles. And this is due to the fact that, like I said, the opportunity for yourself this week, you know, to further your goal is not going to be the one that you kind of imagined, right? You imagine something new, but instead you get to work with what you have, which you haven't developed to its maximum. And for that reason, the two of Pentacles here urges you to abandon established concepts, all right? To abandon plans as well. Just go with the flow. Just take one thing at a time as it comes around, and don't think what could be. Or rather, like, what was the sentence here? So, do not concern yourself with what could be. Concern yourself with what is, and work with it right now. And when something develops tomorrow, then concern yourself with what developed. The accompanied card here is going to be the Ace of Wands. And the formation, it is a passive neutrals. So, it seems that you are not going to be a risky player here, or the cards are advising you not to be a risky player. The less, how can I describe it, you know, the less unfamiliarity the situation has for you, the better, the more chances of success. So if you are baffled about the situation, if you do have a lot of questions, before you do something about it, before you act, it will be best to try to obtain the necessary information, either for the person that you want to be with, either for the project that you want to involve yourself in. You know, it's just, be forewarned, thus forearmed. All right, so that was your weekly tarot reading for July 15th to July 21st, 2019. I hope you enjoyed it and you liked it, guys, and we're going to see each other around. Until then, bye.